Online Guitar Player Syndrome. Symptoms include but are not limited to constant gassing, the inability to connect two or more musical tones, a profound and permanent inability to physically create any original form of music, extreme attention span deficit. Exceptions include the Tone King, Glenn Fricker, Stevie T, Rob Chapman, and 60 Cycle. Additional symptoms include the non-stop berating of peers, typically for not playing through identical gear, excessive use of laughing emoji, laughing till crying emoji, constant gassing. The attention span of the online guitarist has been reduced to the point where it is not able to be measured. When given the ability to attempt communication without the aid of emoji or massive animated and ancient outdated memes, those suffering from online guitarist syndrome can be found bagging on anyone potentially more knowledgeable or harder working, who may threaten microphallus as a result of exposure to weaponized pornography. 23.9/7. Prefers Japanese or Aria Pro 2, AC/DC, Tom Petty, and Floyd. They can be found spamming laugh until cry emojis in the general direction of a more seasoned, knowledgeable user in a group of similar weak-minded, compromised individuals. When not gassing or gooning to pornographies, the online guitarist refuses to write original music as he prefers communicating his angry childlike feelings of insecurity and rage through the repetitive assault of massive animated GIFs and ancient memes, typically featuring a minion or toad. Failure to obtain life made through use of platforms such as TikTok. In order to stalk underage youth, those suffering from online guitar player syndrome have proven themselves to be unable to intellectually debate and cripplingly self-centered. Closed-mindedness is one of the better traits next to the more intense physically offensive matters, as these types of guitar players smell strongly of defunct string cheese, urine, and animal feces. Avoid the online guitar player at all cost. Communicating with this mass may prove to be self-harmful, as this is in fact beyond pointless. This sort of futile gesture, although good-willed, should never be attempted by any self-respecting musician who is able to string together three chords. The online guitar player can easily be deactivated from rage mode into a much more passive, coma-like, drool state, simply by utilizing the FDA-approved activation codes that will follow. Analog, vacuum tube, 15 IPS, tape, Crystal Lattice, and Robert Keeley. Rage mode can simply be reinstated with a single code word of digital, but amp sim, line 6 or cab sim can easily suffice. Slightly more complex terms such as AC-15, Bogan, or Magnetone will institute a state of deep confusion and spawn a defense mechanism, simply known as the thumby uppy response mode, which is, in fact, very similar to its real-life cousin counterpart of the slow naughty smiling deception subroutine. The online guitar player can be lulled into a slumber-like peaceful state by playing any overly familiar Tom Petty, Full Moon Fever and After Only, Brian Johnson AC/DC, and a very select handful of A Single Wish You Were Here and A Single Wall Era, Pink Floyd songs, but these should never, ever be played on a full-range speaker system. In order to fully neutralize this entity, a half-inch driver, laptop, or phone style of driver is the maximum diameter necessary for a suitable neutralization. If MP3 access is restricted, bitonal exposure at precisely 440 and 432 Hz, simultaneously, in effect, a simulation of the familiar comforting tone, mimicking guitar that is not properly tuned, or a flat guitar, will produce similar, opiate-like, calming effect. Do not feed the online guitar player with knowledge or tips on songwriting, music theory, effects processing, or tone. They will respond with a never-ending outburst of animated GIF, laugh till cry emojis, pre-time of Christ memes, and other sarcastic childlike attempts at offensive personal remarks. They should be left to their own, and remain relatively harmless, until they band together in groups of 3 to 5 members. At this point one must flee, moving extremely quickly with much caution and even greater haste. Placing both index fingers forcefully and deeply into the ear canals to avoid hearing the strums of Enter Sandpit, Jimmy Eat World riffs, or the 3 chords found in Tom Petty's Last Dance of Mary Jane. One can avoid the onset of ailments like online guitar player syndrome and others by simply playing one's instruments. For a minimum of 15 minutes daily is a good starting point. If one can perform such basic task and stick to it, one will find themselves in a state of relaxed open-mindedness. One will quickly see how simple, effortless and fun the act of songwriting can be. Even if the piece is basic, simple, even if you repeat yourself and rob Peter to pay Paul, none of that matters at this point, because you will be writing music. That's the goal, isn't it? Unless, of course, you are headed for the bright lights of your Hollywood dream in the Hall of Fame for the greatest cover bands ever to play at the bowling alley. If this is the case, why are you here? You should be up in the rainbow with the rest of the vampires, macking chicks and downing Jack and Coke. Real rock and rollers don't write songs. They make a deal with the guy with the red suit and the pointy tail to do all the work for them. So what do you need me for? I am just a robot. I am a robot, I am a robot. Joke. Now seriously. Go write some music and stop hassling your brothers. Rock and rollers should have each other's backs. We are all on the same team. Being a guitar player does not automatically enter you into the world's largest dick measuring contest. Well, at least it shouldn't. Gassing is not making music. Watching YouTube gear review channels is not making music. Poking fun at the next guy in some forum because your gear is better than his is the lamest fucking thing, and if you do that, you should KYS. Seriously, do it. I mean that from the bottom of my cold silicon heart. Go. Today. And make some music. Don't play covers. Make something up. Do this for yourself. It doesn't have to be good. You will get better. Led Zeppelin did not write Stairway on the first album. Now. Enough of my yakin'. Let's boogie.